بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today very interesting. 2-month-old, preterm, 34 weeks, admitted initially to NICU due to RDS to rule out early onset neonatal sepsis connected to conventional mechanical ventilation, then CPAP until reached room air. At 1 month of the age, the baby developed abnormal movement, focal seizure, and fever, for which diagnosed as meningoencephalitis, late onset sepsis to rule out meningoencephalitis, full septic work uptaken and started on vancomycin and robinum and acyclovir. CSF came bacterial meningitis and sensitive to previous antibiotics. EEG done confirmed electrical seizure, so this is clinical electrical seizure. CT brain done, there is brain hemorrhage. Today, the baby developed seizure in form of a stirring rock, stiffening body, tonic-clonic seizure lasting for few seconds within three times within 1 hour, associated with abnormal breathing and desaturated up to 83% without tachycardia. But the most obvious, there is lower limb scissoring. So the baby given phenobarbital loading dose, 20 milligram per kg, and calcium, glucose, and sodium was checked at that time within normal. After loading dose of phenobarbital, the baby or the seizure stopped, and the baby went for postictal sleep. So what is the home message from the case or the neonatal seizure? Points, the key points, the first key point, jitterness. You have to differentiate between seizure and jitterness before starting anti-epileptic medication. Jitterness, you can elicit it and you can stop it by holding the limb, but the seizure cannot. The second home message, be sure all electrolytes within normal before giving anti-epileptic medication or phenobarbital. Otherwise, if you will give phenobarbital and there is hypocalcemia, hypoglycemia, hyponatremia or hypernatremia, will not stop the seizure. You have to treat the cause first. The third key point, once you correct all the electrolytes, this is the cause of the seizure, hypoglycemia, hypocalcemia, hyponatremia, at that time you can give the phenobarbital. Phenobarbital, you give loading dose 20 milligram per kg and you can reach it to 40 milligram per kg, and you have to check the phenobarbital level to reach to therapeutic level before you give the second line of anti-epileptic medication or seizure control medication. So the key point, first, you have to differentiate between seizure and jitterness. Second, before you start the anti-epileptic medication on phenobarbital, you have to check all electrolytes, glucose, calcium, magnesium within normal to treat the cause before you start anti-epileptic medication. Once all electrolyte within normal and this is true seizure, you can start anti-epileptic medication, phenobarbital, 20 milligram per kg, and you can reach it to 40 milligram per kg, and you have to do phenobarbital level to check the therapeutic level. After that, you can give the second line of medication. Shukran, salamu alaykum.